Hey degenerates, Indy here. If you've watched at least a couple of my videos before or follow me on Twitter, it's a tad obvious that I'm a Nintendo fan. That's right, me, the guy who made a really shitty Animal Crossing video a year ago, is a Nintendo fan, shocker. I have been following and keeping up with Nintendo ever since I played my first video game ever, which happened to be Tinkerbell for the DS. I know. I also wish I could have came out the womb guns blazing playing Cars 2 the video game, but in reality, we don't always get what we want. And as I've gone on throughout my life, Nintendo has always been a constant. I mean, they're half my childhood, they've birthed countless classics and gems and own some of the most renowned and well-praised franchises of all time, but lately, it's become a bit harder to fully support them in their actions as a company. I mean, they haven't always been perfect, and I will never forgive them for Amiibo Festival, but I feel like more recently than ever, they've just lost touch with what made them special in the first place. And a lot of the problems have been rooting from this thing. The Nintendo Bit. The Nintendo Switch was a console released in 2017 by Nintendo that you are most likely familiar with, and don't say you aren't, because it's the fucking Nintendo Switch. Jimmy Kimmel played it. Stop giving me that look. This thing was a big turnaround for Nintendo. See, before this, we had the 3DS and the Voldemort of consoles. You said you owned a Wii U in 2016, and everybody just looked at you like you killed a baby in cold blood. Nintendo was in a rut, and it was kinda obvious to see. Some people still thought that the Wii U was a Wii add-on, and some people were convinced Nintendo would just retire completely because of how little waves they were making in the video game world. Well, that was all about to change with the release of this bad boy. It was a 2-in-1, and apparently it could be docked to your TV and taken on the go. You could finally look like a virgin from the outside of your house! Nintendo knew they would be nothing without their exclusives, and they used this to their advantage for the first year in the Switch heavily. Finally, the open-world Zelda game the Wii U was first announced with was finally dropping on its release date, a new open-world Mario game akin to that of Sunshine and Galaxy was scheduled for the same year, Metroid Prime 4 was coming, allegedly, and Splatoon 2, along with tons of older Wii U games that didn't get the justice they deserved on their original piece of hardware, were on their way too. This sounded fantastic. And then the system launched. In the beginning of the console's lifespan, the UI was a bit of a surprise, with it taking a bit of a more minimalist approach and feeling a tad bare bones as compared to their competitors and previous consoles. Only 2 themes, no eShop music, no folders, no Internet Explorer, no Netflix, no messaging system, no personality. But it had Breath of the Wild, so who gave a shit? This was obviously a bit more forgivable for the time, and many assumed that more themes and quality of life updates would soon roll out for the system, you know, seeing as the console itself only just came out. And many assumed wrong. We are 4 years into this shit, and nothing has changed except a useless extra icon in the bottom left corner that did nothing the eShop couldn't already display. This thing feels like a lifeless, identityless iPad that happens to play Nintendo games, and honestly, going back to the Wii U's home screen, it makes me miss the console a little bit. Ew, I can't believe I just said that I missed the Wii U, but see, even the Wii U has Netflix. What happened with Netflix, Nintendo? These are all features that honestly don't seem that important in retrospect, but once they're gone, it's hard not to miss them. It's just the little things too, man, like what happened to the activity log? On the 3DS, Nintendo would tell you the date you picked up a specific game, how many hours you spent playing it, and its estimated time and cause of death. On the Switch, it just shows you nothing about your playtime unless you go to your profile, wait 10 days after first playing a game, and even then it just shows you a rounded number of how many hours you spent playing the damn thing. And on Nintendo's other older consoles, there was just random cool free shit to do, even if you didn't have games bought for the system yet. There was the Wii Channel with its various icons, Mii Editor, the 3DS with Kirby Fighters, that weird flying head game, the AR cards, so many fun things to do that just didn't require a boatload of cash to download and have fun with. On the Switch, simple free fun shit is just non-existent. Everything is locked behind a paywall, even the online service, which in previous generations has always been free. And even download play is just fucking gone from the DS/3DS. Everyone has to buy the $300 console, the $60 game, the $20 online fee. It's fucking ridiculous. And that's not even really a problem with Nintendo. I think it's more a problem with gaming as a whole, but it's still sad to see Nintendo only decide to get with the times when it makes them an effing monopoly. And that's not even talking about the actual online service itself. Well, what does it get you, you may ask? jack shit. It gives you a couple of old NES games and only a very specific handful of SNES games. They couldn't even bother to put the ones that everybody fucking wants on there, like Earthbound or Super Mario RPG or Chrono Trigger. Nope. Have fucking prehistoric man. Now, I don't know if it's because they just can't get the rights or what, but they're all on the Wii U and 3DS, so I think they're just messing with us at this point. Speaking of messing with us, what the fuck are these dial-up Windows 95-ass gaming servers? Isn't Super Smash Bros. A serious game used in tournaments? Why is there a fucking minute-long input response and constant freezing anytime you want to join a match? And it isn't just Smash Bros., it's every game that decides it wants to have online made by Nintendo. You know you fucked up when the bootleg-ass Fortnite Switch version has better servers than your first-party titles. And I don't even want to think about the Nintendo Switch Online app. And anyone remember the Nintendo Switch Online app? You know what? I'm not even going to explain it. I just want you to look at this image and tell me if it makes any sense to you. Because I've been looking at it every day for the past 3 years, and I still can't decipher any sense out of it. Sure, Nintendo's always been a bit questionable and iffy with online chat, but holy shit, the bar was already so low, I didn't think it was even a possibility that they could mess it up as bad as they did. I didn't know we were playing fucking Limbo over here. All you needed was a straight messaging system, a party voice chat feature built into the console, and that was it. We aren't asking for much. We don't need another Miiverse. We're just asking for the bare fucking minimum, and Nintendo just does not have the slightest clue in what the hell it is they're doing or what their audience wants. It just makes it more frustrating when things like this happen, because it's not like Nintendo was just a screw-up company. When they get shit right, they really nail it down and set the standard. So they must have some level of self-awareness, but they still end up just consistently making reckless and stupid decisions with their brand. It's like they walk into a meeting and start it out like, hey guys, let's release the most beloved game of the decade, and while we're at it, let's time exclusive a couple of these new Mario games. I don't get it. There's no transparency or communication from these guys either, so it just feels a lot more like they just don't care. And also, I find it a bit funny that in the trailer for these consoles, this thing is advertised as a perfect on-the-go product. And it is. If you look at it from an angle and squint your eyes, a 1 to 2 hour battery life is perfect for on the go. The stand in the back of the console is pathetic, and the build durability and quality is questionable. It was rated the most fragile electronic of 2019. I think I'd have less paranoia taking my fucking GameCube to the park. I dropped this dumb thing one time in my home on the couch, and the Joy-Con had a fucking miscarriage from the system, and I had to get it repaired. I remember dropping my 3DS down the stairs in my old house, and it's still coming out perfectly fine and playable. What the hell happened here? This design feels rushed, cheap, flimsy. I mean, not all of it's bad, and some of these issues can be fixed with third-party solutions, but still, it bothers me how expensive and fragile this thing is while they encourage you to go outdoors and risk breaking your console and simultaneously losing these millimeter $60 cartridges. Hey, anybody seen my spare copy of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe? It's the size of a wasp and overpriced. Tell me if you find it. And then there's the technical issues that happen even if you're extremely careful with your Switch, like Joy-Con drift. This has happened to two of my Joy-Cons so far and has affected pretty much all of my friends who own a Switch. Nintendo offers to fix it through their Nintendo Repair Service, though most of the time the Joy-Con will just end up drifting again after a couple months when it comes back, so what's the point? And Nintendo doesn't even bother to improve the design or anything, they just keep selling faulty hardware and hope that we don't notice. And this whole time I haven't even bothered to talk about the games. The games are probably what saved the console as a whole, besides, you know, the quote-unquote portability. And whenever Nintendo puts out a new game or puts effort into a great port, it's awesome and I'll gladly shell out $60. But the sad thing is, for a lot of these games, they don't put a ton of effort in and still end up charging full price. If it has Mario in the title, you can bet your ass that thing is gonna cost $60. I mean, just look at Mario 3D All-Stars, a compilation of three games that are, all combined, decades old, with practically no side content or features added to the collection besides just a straight port of the games. And the controls for half of these, especially Galaxy, just have little to no effort or thought put into them. Yet they still charge $60 for it and treat it like it's a brand spanking new game. Oh look, a remake of a Game Boy game. I wonder how much this one's gonna cost.
$60.
Oh look, another re-release. of another singular decade-old game. Maybe this one's gonna be...
$60.
And on the topic of old games, where the hell are they? Nintendo is one of the strongest backlogs in gaming history, yet they just make more than half of it unavailable for purchase officially and get so damn heated when people decide to play it unofficially and emulate. It's like, what the hell did you expect to happen? You're refusing to sell it. What do you want us to do? And in the rare occurrence they finally decide to sell an old game, they charge $60 for three games that they know damn well everybody wants, and they take advantage of that and overprice it. Oh look, and it's a timed exclusive too. That's just great, isn't it? That's just splendid. And then there's the fact that the Switch's hardware is becoming very rapidly outdated. Sure, it can play Smash Bros. Okay, and many other games look fine, but have you even glanced at The Witcher 3? I've played around 50 hours of this game, so I think I can comment. And while yes, if a game is truly enjoyable, the graphics won't matter, but at some point, you gotta look at yourself in the mirror and think, maybe it's time for an upgrade. And when half of your new first-party titles have trouble just trying to maintain 30 FPS in handheld, it makes me a bit worried for what's to come in the next couple of years. But who cares, though? We're only two generations behind in hardware. I'm totally not in an abusive relationship. And even though I have been ragging the fuck out of this thing for the past 8 minutes, I genuinely still do like it. It's a solid way to play tons of indie titles and exclusive Nintendo titles. And some of my greatest video game experiences have come out of this, even if it hasn't all been perfect. And also, I'm not living in a fantasy world. I know that Nintendo doesn't owe me or its fans shit. Its only goal is to make money at the end of the day, as it would be with any company. They aren't some special exception. But it still just makes me sad because there is so much potential to be had here with this console. It's... okay right now, but if Nintendo put in the effort they've always decided to put in with their other consoles, this thing could be amazing. But Nintendo doesn't really seem to care. It's not like they're some small indie dev team with little to no funding. They're quite literally the richest company in Japan. They have the resources, the connections, the ability to make this thing the best console it can be. Yet they still continue to make these baffling, confusing, anti-consumer decisions that just make me question being a fan of theirs altogether. Yeah, this company, it's not good. I'm IndieGenerate, and subscribe for more angry, useless video game takes. And also, if you bought Mario 3D All-Stars, I want to detect the dumbasses. Anyways, remember to take a shower, and I'll see you later. Bye.